Hello everyone, thanks for coming to listen to our presentation. My name is Cengiz Gunay, and this work has been done together with my colleague Anca Doloc-Mihu at the School of Science and Technology at Georgia Gwinnett College. We created this OER for a software engineering course, undergraduate software engineering course, which is focused on agile style development. And it's almost complete. It's in a draft format, but it's almost complete. And we're here to tell you about how we built this book, because we think the way we built this book is very easily maintainable and it's freely hosted. So I think this could be a general way of like other disciplines and other professors to host their books. And specifically, if someone wants to change our book, it's very easy for them to adopt and create like a copy of our book and then modify it the way they want. Basically looks something like this. There's like menu on the left hand side where you can select different chapters, and for example if you click on a single chapter, you'll see you'll immediately see a slideshow, because we designed the book instead of having a text and also like a slideshow deck. We only have the slideshow deck because in our field, in the IT field, students are very resistant to reading long texts. We have been observing it for a while, and as professors, we prefer to be able to modify just one location instead of maintaining text and also slides. So we only focus on slides, and we also, but we do have like reading links from the slides. Sometimes there are links to go out. So as you can see, that's one of the features. And the other feature is that, as you can see, the slides are on a website, and they're not a PowerPoint or not a PDF. So this natively on the website, this has a lot of advantages. First of all, it makes it very accessible and very mobile friendly. And also it's very easy to use any kind of web resource or having outgoing links to any other websites. So that's in general the contents of our book. Now I want to mention how we made this book and why is it special and how you would benefit from doing something similar. So from any of these pages, there's always like a click on edit on GitHub link in here. If you click on that, you'll be ending up in the source code on the github.com website. And actually the book itself, if you look at the URL, you'll see that it's hosted at github.io. That's where GitHub pages websites are hosted. This is a free service from github.com, which is owned by Microsoft. And the source code looks like this. And under the source code, there will be a README file that explains the technology that we're using and how to adopt this book. How does the content look for this book? How would the code for the book? You will not see the HTML files in here. So even though the final site is an HTML website, you will not see the site in here. Instead, it's going to be some code and some content mix. And the technology that we're using is called Hugo. It will basically take this content and produce the HTML output for us. And how does this content look like? Let me just show you. I told you that it's going to be simple. So let's see if it's going to be simple or not. For example, when we go to the content, first things we see, like there are some other folders and there's an index.md file. Now the word MD stands for markdown, and it looks like this. So this is already rendered in GitHub, but if you go to the first page, you'll see welcome, we're still adding materials. So you'll see the same thing in here. But if you want to see the actual code for this file, so this is actually a simple file, so you can click on the row button in here and you'll see the text inside this file. So the MD file is basically a text file where certain there are markup elements. So this, the pound sign actually gives a heading format, so this becomes a heading, and the rest of it is regular text except the about page. The square brackets makes the link, and this is the target for the link. So if you go to here, you'll see that about, when you click on about, it's going to go to the about page. So that's one of the things that we like about these static website generators, that they are very easy to maintain because everything is text files. There is no commercial software used. There's no Word document or PDF or PowerPoint document that are difficult to modify. Everything is text files and it's very easy to edit. And at the top, you'll see some metadata within the three dashes. For example, the title of the page, which shows up here. And description, it says homepage. That's going to be shown somewhere. And author may be in here, and there are some modification dates. I also want to show you one of the slide presentations that we browsed earlier. For example, we go to the Agile development and look at the Scrum chapter. So this will correspond, so Agile development, Scrum, so those will be like the folders, and when you click on this, we will see this slide, opening slide. And let's just look at how that looks like if you click on this file and click on raw to see the contents. So there will be the title, and outputs will indicate that it's using the reveal technology to create this slide presentation. So reveal.js is a library that we're using to create these slide presentations. And this, the plus signs and the metadata. And then the first thing is a Hugo command. So the double curly brackets, it's not going to be too many of these, but there are some commands that we use. It will create a title page. This is a command that we created for this book. And it will provide this kind of page. It will put the title on top. The title comes from the metadata. And then it will put the name of the book. This will be in the configuration file that I didn't show you. And then it will put the authors of the book or the chapter. So if there's authors specified in the metadata, it will put that. Otherwise, it will put the default authors for the book. And it may, if you can decide to show a figure if you want, and here is showing a scrum position in the rugby game. That's where the word scrum is coming from in software development. And that will be the first slide. And if we go to the next slide, there will be another scrum slide, and there will be some text in here with the bullet points. And that will be after the three dashes. This will be the next slide. So this will be the title of the slide. And the word fragment allows us to have an animation. So that's how different bullet points are showing up separately. And just putting, and this is the rest of it is HTML in here. It could have been written differently too, but HTML is also fine. And that will be one slide, and then it will be a second slide in here under the three dashes. So each of these sections are separate slides, and they have fragments. They may have images and figures. The picture is going to show up as an image. This is another image. So I hope you get the point how the slides are presented. They're very, very straightforward. There's no PowerPoint. There's no fiddling around, moving things around on the screen. You just write them in text format. That makes it a bit more rigid. It's not as easy as PowerPoint, but it also makes it very, very easy to modify, share, and make it very accessible for adapting this book and changing the book contents. So all of this information is in here, and I would like to also show you how you can adapt this book for your own class. Basically, the adapter book is using GitHub's native forking system. When you click on fork, basically it will make a copy of this project in your account, and you'll be freely, completely free to edit it. And I also set up in here an action for building the Hugo website. So every time like you make a change in this website, it will create an automatic Hugo website automatically. So when you fork this, you will get the same feature into your account, and you can show it in your own site. And there are instructions for it in the README file. So then I can show you one example. For example, if you look at the forks, there are different forks of this site, and this is another copy of this website that we're maintaining. In this one, for example, there are more chapters under workshops, so we have like more in here. And that's how you make adapt it for yourself. So just to wrap up, I would like to thank you for coming to our listening to our presentation, and I hope you saw that there is like a very easy to share and maintain way of creating books for your classes. And if you're interested in software development, you can actually adapt and modify our book. We'll be looking forward to your feedback. I have provided links on our sched description for the book itself, the slide system, the source code on GitHub, and also we have a little feedback form. If you want to give us any feedback or adopt our book, please take a moment. Thank you very much.